So look, we have heard government officials say that the president should have been straightforward with the American people, and he was not. Not just Democrats, the by the way. I want you to take a listen. Here's Senator Susan Collins, Republican of Maine, followed by Democratic Governor Phil Murphy of New Jersey. Take a listen to them.
The American people can take hard facts, and he had an obligation as president to be straightforward with them.
If we had known that earlier, we would have shut the state meaningfully earlier. It's inconceivable to me that we wouldn't have been able to save lives as a result of that.
All right, may I respond?
Bipartisan
now, Jake?
Consensus, bipartisan consensus, yet that the president should have been straightforward.
Can I respond here, Jake? Okay. You have to go back to February and March. We're in the fog of war from the China virus. There are competing views as to whether this is simply the flu or whether this is very serious.
What are the competing views?
And we go through, hang on. The scientist, look, you had,
talking about
you had
something
Nancy
else.
Pelosi dancing with scarves in Chinatown at the end of February saying, come on down. You had de Blasio and Cuomo in March saying, come on down. You
Why
had
wasn't Dr. the president
Fauci
straightforward
saying
with the American
that there
people?
Was low. He was straightforward.
No, he wasn't.
There was, look, Jake, I'm telling you
what our strategy is. Just answer the very basic question. Right, you want to talk about what you want to talk about, okay?
You're cherry picking.
No, I'm not cherry picking. On February 7th, he knew that it was in the air, that it was five times deadlier than the flu.
No,
five times deadlier. That's on the tape.
He expressed that to Woodward, but at the same time,
2 weeks later, he's saying that the flu is deadlier than the coronavirus. Why wasn't he honest?
You just don't want to listen, Jake. You just
I want you to answer the question.
I am answering your question. You just don't like the answer. The answer is, in February, all the way through the middle of March, when the World Health Organization finally said there was a pandemic and China was hiding the information, finally, that's when we knew that there was a pandemic. And you know what, Jake? We were at that point prepared for the worst. In February, we were moving mountains on PPE, therapeutics, testings, and vaccines so that in the time that we needed those things, we got those things. And it's a miracle what we've been doing on vaccine development. We have a possibility of getting a vaccine by the end of the year. And I put that right in a memo on February 9th under the advice of the president in terms of getting on this situation because it might be serious. You can't have it both ways, Jake. You simply
can't. I'm not trying to have it both
ways. In February, nobody knew. No, nobody knew. Not
the president.
He's not you, not Nancy Pelosi, not Bill de Blasio.
He knew it was deadlier than the flu, and he was lying to the American people 2 weeks later.
Jake, you're cherry picking.
I'm not cherry picking.
But you can say, look, I think all of this is asked and answered, Jake. Look, here's the thing.
He was not honest with the American people.
You're
not answering the question.
You're not honest with the American people. CNN is not honest with the American people.
Okay.
CNN, you want to go there? I mean,
I said you're not answering the question. Here's the thing. Thank you, Peter Navarro. We just played tape. You didn't answer the question.
No, you can't say that.
You didn't answer the question? No, you didn't.
Repeatedly, Jake. You just didn't like the answer.
Okay, Peter Navarro, thank you so much. I appreciate your time today. Thank you so much. And I would just like to remind the American people watching that the United States has less than 5% of the world's population, and the United States has more than 20% of the world's coronavirus deaths. That is a fact. It does not matter how many times he insults CNN.